Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, with our main topic today. Well, President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi witnessed the inauguration of a number of national projects for the development of Sinai Peninsula, including the key Ahmed Hamdi second tunnel, which connects Africa to Asia in the event that took place yesterday in the Suez Governorate on Tuesday. To shed more light on this, we have the pleasure to have with us this morning in the breakfast show Dr. Mustafa Wali, the economic expert. Good morning, Dr. Wali.
Good morning, thank you.
Well, Dr. Wali, could you give us your insight concerning the importance of the projects that President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi inaugurated yesterday?
First of all, in this occasion, we all should remember that President Sisi will never let a chance to highlight and attend by himself the inauguration of what I call, actually, all of them are mega projects, especially in this area when it comes to Suez Canal area and the Suez Economic Zone there and Sinai projects. I'm talking about now the eastern front of Egypt, the eastern side of Egypt, which is very important, especially linking Sinai to the motherland to so that we feel that we belong to Sinai as citizens, and our friends and our brothers living there are Egyptian. They have the chance to development. They have the chance to reap the fruits of the development all over the country. And it was great, actually, what I have witnessed yesterday and what I have seen before in this area.
Yes. So, Dr. Wali, before we go on air, you were talking to me about the importance of attracting investments. What would this projects that were inaugurated yesterday would help in attracting investments to Egypt?
Well, mainly the projects yesterday were the outcome of the development we are looking for this area. That's something a little bit different of the investment we are looking to have in this area. But in generally, they are tied together. Because, for example, if we look at the main project which was inaugurated yesterday, it's by all measures, it's fantastic and very impressive and very important project, is to have another artery between the east and west of Egypt, from east to Sinai, I mean Egypt to get into Sinai. To me, increasing the arteries of getting to the heartland, which is, of course, the whole Egypt is the heart, but when you talk about all these remote areas, not remote, I mean geographically, look at the south, far east, far west, all should be feeling that they are integrated part. The connection, the physical connection, is very important, and it proved not only for us, I mean, as our experience, it's the experience of the developed world over years and centuries even of development. And for people who knows the importance or sense it more than anybody, the importance of connecting physically the areas and the remote areas and the whole country to get interconnected, so that you feel that you belong to this area, you are from this area, you can go around, you can have business there, you can start, then you start to calculate what is your potential in each of these areas, potential for development. And that such projects make it a possibility.
Yes, yes. So, Dr. Wali, what were the steps or the measures that were taken by the state in order to provide an attractive climate for investment?
Yes. Investment is one of the cornerstones for development. Yes. And countries who deserve investments should actually prepare and make themselves ready to accept foreign direct investment. We manage as a government and as a people and the policies to increase the chance and develop and correct the problems when it comes to foreign direct investment. And it's quite evident because, for example, last year, due to COVID, the total FDIs pumped into Africa was 40 billion. while the year before it was 47, which is a decline. For us, we increased our share actually by 16%. Actually, we went up to 6 billion, which is a 5.9. Such figures are very important because real figures, you know, shows that we are at least in Africa as a continent, we are the people who can attract, which means that we can afford to have very good climate for investment.
Yes.
The only thing is that how to increase it, and by time, of course, and with COVID going away and the world back again to boost to booming in investment, we can have our lion's share, which we deserve, actually.
Yes. So, Dr. Wadi, in your opinion, how does the increase in the Suez Canal, the revenues, I mean, reflect the canal's ability to raise the degree of confidence in the Suez Canal as the best international shipping lane?
Yeah. There were some events, you know, international events happening on our ground and in Suez Canal area and in Suez Canal itself, which showed that how important the Suez Canal as the most, the safest and the shortest connection between the two giants.
Also providing all facilities for the ships passing.
So it was proved. And we talk specifically about this drifting of this Panamanian ship, which was a big story, and then it gone, and now the time came that she would come back again in her way back to Asia and passing by the Suez Canal.
Yes.
That shows how important and how is this. So the increase in our revenue in Suez Canal, which about 10% is about $500. That's something in the situation where, in general, the movement of trade is going a little bit slow.
Yes. So to what extent does the Suez Canal economic zone contribute to increasing Egyptian exports to all countries of the world?
Yeah. You know, geography, when it comes to economy, is very important. Water passages and channels, which is actually connecting seas or even between oceans and seas, are very well-known story, economic story established across the world. You look at the world and similar such things, you will find it booming and well-known to everybody because maritime and trade is coming through ships is essential for the world. We have a unique, really unique situation when it comes to geography, connecting the Red Sea with the Mediterranean, and after the Mediterranean and after the Red Sea, there are two big continents needing each other, and we are in the way where we can help. This is the simplest expression of the importance of this area. Now, we focus on this area, and I'm expecting a lot to come out of this area with a lot of big initiatives in the world, like, for example, the Chinese road and the belt.
The belt, yes.
Such projects where we are in this geographical, it's unique. Egypt is gift of her people, its people, but also the geography.
So, Dr. Wadi, how has the economic zone been affected after the implementation of the Belt and Road Initiative?
Well, it's not yet felt, but at least in the programs, you know, the Chinese themselves, according to their policy, because they are going around the world, there are certain areas where it is having a kind of, you know, relative more importance than the others. One of them is our area in general. I mean, Egypt as gate to Africa with the Suez Canal is there. So there will be a lot of cooperation and a lot of investment from the Chinese side to fulfill their, you know, total objective of having this belt. But in the meanwhile, we have also our relations with the West and the East, I mean with Europe and Asia, where they are manufacturing. There are manufacturing countries would like to have a competitive area to have their products to distribute to the world. So We can have African, we can have Asian, and we can have European to be working there, which is happening now in this Suez Canal zone, yes. Economic Suez Canal zone. That's the importance of it.
So, Dr. Wadi, so how does entering into a commercial partnership with the major industrial countries in the world would affect the development of the Suez Canal zone?
Yeah, actually, the importance of Suez Canal zone is reflected that we can attract such things.
Yes.
So, the importance of the Suez Canal area. The Suez Canal zone, exactly, the economic zone. It's now clear because you can see there, I mean, if we are talking about nationalities, you know, we will find there the Russian, first the Chinese already are there, then we have the Russians also are there, we have some other. The latest are the Polish are coming to get into project, with of course some big international entities, industrial entities are working there, plus of course the Egyptian companies which are well known internationally, and they have their product and they export. I mean, this area will be the hub for flourishing, economic flourishing in Egypt.
Yes.
Soon.
So, to what extent does the Suez Canal contribute to advancing the Egyptian national economy and also transforming Egypt into a global trade and logistics center?
Yeah, if we take the last part, the global trade and center, and you know, it's a hub. It's a hub. It will be even more important hub than the whole area around us, you know, because it's extended up to the west of Africa, northwest, because we are in the heart to Africa as Africa. And meanwhile, we are the crossroad to Asia and the crossroad to Europe when it comes to international trade.
Yes.
That in itself can assure you or ensure for you as a country and as economy that you are exposed to the best practices in industry, the best norms of dealing in trade, and simply we can be another big hub in the global on the globe for international trade when it comes to trade.
Yes.
But also our gain from experience will be great.
Yes. So, Dr. Wadi, to what extent has the economic zone that is surrounding the Suez Canal been planned according to a future vision that takes into account or consideration the various dimensions of the expected future development in maritime transport and international trade exchange?
Yeah. I will start with the most important thing.
Yes.
Which is the connectivity. I mean the roads.
Yes.
And that's essential part, of course, together with the infrastructure, where if you can afford, if you can supply, if you can maintain the adequate, even for the future demand, energy and water and all the necessary items, utilities needed for investment at large.
Yes.
You can't have investment without energy. Now we are doing very well in energy. We will have soon more than what we have. When it comes to road, and in my mind it's very important because road is part of the connectivity. Of course, being on the Suez Canal area between the Red Sea and the Mediterranean, that in itself is something. But also the inroads which connect Cairo and Upper Egypt with such places where material is needed, local material is needed to be submitted there. People transport is there. So you look at, for example, I'll give you one simple example. I was shocked last year that I go from Cairo to Sokhna and I find, oh my God, it's 12 lane road. All of a sudden, within few months, I found such. That in itself, very impressive for investment, by the way.
Yes.
That's what the investor look for before getting into any real business. They study well,
Yes.
And they make their calculations.
Yes.
They are very careful people.
Yes. The president also yesterday inaugurated hospitals and also the new tunnel of Ahmed Hamdi,
yes.
the second
yes.
tunnel, because yes. the first tunnel was built in the year 1981,
yeah, yeah, yeah.
and nowadays the new tunnel is built that is expected to double the investments and also provide job opportunities
yeah.
In Sinai, as the president have mentioned. What's your comment?
Let's have the last item, which is to me is very important, is jobs. The word jobs.
Providing yes. job opportunities?
Yes, yes. yes. It goes without saying, while you are going building these projects and working
yes.
on it, you are your experience, and that
yes.
in itself is a great gain. It will develop over the future, and where this will be actually proven for better understanding of the international business, of the international technologies, which is new technologies. That's to me is very important. But meanwhile, if we talk about what we gain of working with international community, at least more or less, if we have a final. I have to talk specific about this point because I know it's important. If you have a product which an end product which was assembled or produced, manufactured in this area, then okay, it's by this company, and you know the standard norm say it's this company, which is international company, could be, or a joint venture company, whatever, but it will give where was the origin of manufacturing. That's a standard, you
yes.
know. That in itself would show it was in Egypt. So it means that in Egypt, the facilities are there, you know, that you have top class or world class product. That's
yes.
very important.
Yes.
A lot of other things are very important, but I'm talking about these two things.
Yes. Concerning the doubling the investment that is expected about the Ahmed Hamdi Tunnel 2.
I don't know what's meant by doubling the
it would facilitate
yeah
yes.
in this sense yes of course
yes.
because if you look at yesterday in the presentation of the facilities of the structure of this fantastic tunnel, it's state of the art in everything,
yes,
especially when it comes to the safety, which is very very important for such kind of passage or crossroads tunneling and underwater.
Yes.
That's very, very important. And it goes without saying that what we have seen there yesterday on the TV and what's on the ground, that it is built and operating to the best standards
yes.
of similar tunnels in the world.
Yes.
That in itself will give the investor, even local investor, will give him the comfort that he will make sure that he can maintain the continuous delivery of his goods from each side, if he wants, of course he needs, and saving the time is essential, saving the time in industry, and then you know the efficient production time is essential. All this is a big matrix, you know, in engineering it's a big matrix.
Yes.
If you feel it and you get to the best, you get the end product, you get the best end side, you know, or the other side of the equation. Simple
yes.
as that.
Yes. So, Dr. Wali, to what extent does the economic zone and the projects that were inaugurated yesterday would contribute to the establishment of new urban societies?
Yeah, of course. Yeah. You can imagine while you are having these projects and later on the development and you can have investment and then you have a community. Sure, it will be urban community because mainly it will be industry. And even if it's agro-industry, then urbanism, the idea of the concept of urbanism, urbanizing the areas, is there. That in itself guaranteed once the investment will be there because people must be there because people are the workforce. And we can see, we have some experience right now in some areas in Egypt. For the concept of urbanizing. And I should not forget that recently we were awarded, you know, kind of United Nations prize for the Ministry of Housing and Urbanizations. Yes. You know, it is a big and very valuable prize actually. This Ministry of Housing and Urbanizing, you know, especially the department responsible for urbanization,
yes,
and the reconstruction, got, yes, the award out of 167, I remember, candidate.
Yes.
That's something we should always, focus on what is positive to our country.
Yeah.
We should.
Yes.
Media should play its role in this. Should.
Providing awareness, of course. Yes, Dr. Wali, President Abdel Fattah Sisi yesterday also said that the development network in Sinai is to be completed within the coming 2 years, whether for urban tourism or agricultural, yes, development.
Yes, yes.
So, to add about this, do you see the importance of the cooperation, international cooperation in building Sinai?
Yes, of course. Why not?
So tell me about this.
You know, any project which is at the end is feasible and profitable to Egypt, where it should be some partner with,
yes,
with the minimum even of technical assistance or know-how. This is what always I believed in long ago. The minimum we can get out of joint venture of getting to is international.
So you see that there should be some cooperation in order to with other countries.
If there is a chance for this, why not? We have it.
If
we have
countries are providing
yes,
help.
Yes, yes. And the minimum we can get, and we can handle it, and this very profitable, the minimum, yes, of such cooperation is the technical assistance.
Yes. Yes. So the president also yesterday inaugurated a number of hospitals, like the St. Catherine Central Hospital,
yeah,
also the Rawaisat Family Medicine Center in Sharm el Sheikh, yeah, and the Family Medical Center in the Suez Governorate.
Well, I think Egypt now is undertaking under of course the site and instruction and the president instruction. This national health,
yes,
insurance, you know, this is another very big and a mega project for the Egyptian people, their health, and started with Port Said, and I hope it will be a successful story. This will make a success story which can be repeated. I think caring for the Egyptian people's health is evident, and we feel it, we witness this. The only thing that we are, alhamdulillah, inshallah, we are 100 million and this needs a lot, but we are proceeding.
Yes.
Let's hope we can,
yes,
we can get to it.
I thank you very much for joining us today,
you,
in the Breakfast Show.
Thank you
for providing us with this valuable information
and explaining
everything.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Mustafa Wali, economic expert.
Thank you for coming today. My pleasure.
Well, I thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, for following me in this segment. My name is Amal Mukhtar. I leave you now with my colleague, Shireen Adel, and the rest of the segments in the Breakfast Show.